What's up, guys? So I'm gonna tie a Kelson fly, one of the earliest. It's called the Ray Mead. It's a pattern that I actually like for fishing. It's got the brown and yellow colors and some silver to it. Yeah, so hope you will enjoy my first video. So I will start tying the tag. And since it's for fishing, it's gonna be a kind of quick tie. Hope you enjoy it. Tinsel I have prepared, cut the wire so it won't be as thick. I fix that a bit and I pull that off. Just like that. And I tie it in and secure it. Oops. Then I use my thumb to make it quite even. Light blue. Then when you use the silk, make sure you don't touch the hook because it's very delicate. The hook size is a 1/0. Oops. Then I will tie in the butt. Make sure it's lies centered. And always, it's like the foundation. as you can see, I started a bit not there. I started there. That's, I think, will match the wings better. So when I tie in this, the angle will be quite right. If I had the angle lower down, it would have become more downwards. So that's why I... Then again, this fly is for fishing. So hopefully you don't see all of my mistakes, but yeah. Put that extra off. This is in the center. Then I have some orange. Then I don't know how necessary this is, but it's time for the her black. Round three. Lapse. I try to make this a bit even. It's time for the ribbing. Make sure it's on the bottom of the hook shank. Yellow. Backwards and then forth. And if you keep the right angle, if you have any broken splits, it will follow it down the line. Secure that piece. Cut it off. And I have some grizzly hackle. The original should have an Irish grey, but yeah, this is whiting grizzly. I think it will give it a nice touch. But so I prepared it by pulling it down. Tie this in. Make sure it's on the bottom. And keep that aligned. Then I have some flat tinsels. The original is like round ribbing, but yeah, I will try with this. So if I start to run, all of a sudden, it's because I have a kid asleep. So just hope that he will remain asleep during this fly. Work the thread to the top and start working with this. Now the picture I've seen of this fly, I haven't seen a real one. It's this part with the oval ribbing. Looks kind of tacky, so I'm gonna try this one. I'm gonna try to go back and forth to just ensure that there's no black showing. This is also a part where you don't want to slip, because it has happened before and I'm sure it will happen again. Gives a nice flash in the water. Secure that. Tighten it a bit. Use a different scissor, not my shorter scissor for that, because it will break it. I don't know if I'm being ridiculous, but yeah. Then I'm gonna start with this, the ribbing. And I want it to align with my hackle, just like that, and then this lap, hopefully it will start right there, so that I don't overcross it. Well, don't cross it. Actually, kind of nice with gold and silver and yellow. Gets a nice touch. Secure this one. Cut it. Then I would just pick off a little bit. So that it don't take that much space for the eye later on, but yeah, it's for fishing, so. I take the grizzly hackle. Some of them have been put on the wrong direction, but see if I get this to align. So it's a fly from the 19th century. It's from the George Mortimer Kelson, who lived during 1836 to 1920s. Shouldn't be talking too much while doing this, because it's, as you can see, it's messing up my performance. I think that will do. So did two extra turns with the hackle. Cut it off. Pull back the hair. Cut off some extra. Thank you. secure it. Kind of like the thunder and lightning body. Then I use some teal. It's three laps, but yeah. We'll see. I don't really like teal, but let's see how this goes. I think the hackle is an important piece for the looks of the fly and also the how you're gonna fish it. I think it's quite important that it lies correctly. Not like that. And you want it to be like doubled so that they don't have any fibers pointing the other direction. As you can see, I turn it backwards. If I see, I know the fiber is pointing in the wrong. But then again, that's kind of not necessary. Secure it. Cut the remainings. Do a few turns, cut off the top, and just way up, not down the hook, this can stay. So this is a fly that don't have a underwing, it's only have one wing. Fluffy. So fluffy you can die. Great. Not really necessary to cut that off, but yeah. If it annoys you, do something about it maybe. I'll prepare the wing. Black and brown. trying to get them aligned. It like that. And I secure it by holding it like that, two turns. You want this to align on your finger. That and then secure it. I'm sure this will look quite messy, but bend it upwards. See? Sorry, my fat fingers. Some extra turns. I can feel it pushes the wing, but we will see how it gets. Not entirely happy with the result, so I'm going to do it one more time. Also a look about that. Second chance, hopefully. My bobbin holder is quite hot. It's a stone foe. Try this again. Then it's time for the some cheeks, or yeah. Yeah, it's part of the wing, but and the eyes. Then instead of chatterer, I used just some need to sneeze. On top of the jungle cop. And it's colored, so I think it makes a pretty good detail. Some baby feathers, you know. Cut off the top. Time for the topping. So I prepared one. Yeah. Flex man. Used to have fat man, but I don't know the difference, but yeah. So this, I think it's gonna be a nice fishing fly. Not the best proportions on the head and stuff, but it's a durable fly.